Hello, Popaholics. It's me, Dr. Sandra Lee. You also know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. What a kind of crazy pop this was. This is a gentleman who actually traveled from pretty far. He came from Chicago area, I think, or the Midwest area, and flew down to see me with his family. He had watched some of my videos, and he had a pretty sizable cyst on his back, maybe the size of like a plum.
Been saving itself in there, I think, huh? Yowzers, you got some old skin in there.
You know, I kind of say cysts and blackheads and all these kind of pops are sort of like snowflakes. There's never one the same. And in this case, this was a pretty dark one. It was almost black. An epidermoid cyst is a sac that contains macerated keratin or wet skin cells under there. And so imagine if you're darker complected, you can have darker skin cells that are going to be collected under your skin.
So you can get this whole cyst out and never come back again. You gotta dissect the whole wall out and everything.
If you squeeze things out, the cyst gets smaller, but it never completely goes away because you have the sac still trapped under there. So the best treatment option to completely remove a cyst so it doesn't come back is to do an excision or to try to in some way remove the sac completely, which is what you see us do here. The sac wall was pretty well defined. It was thin, as it usually is, but pretty well defined, and it kind of looked like a plum coming out, I guess, like a dried, shriveled up plum coming out, and it was quite interesting to see. It was quite satisfying to remove it.
Physicians and surgeons, let me help you.
This is somebody that we're gonna see in room 4.
Okay.
In a little bit, okay, mm-hmm. And I'm gonna have you put some stuff together for me.
Okay.
My name is Taj, and I have basically a bunch of little puffy bumps that turn into big painful boils. If you can see the bumps here and then, like on my chest, I'm kind of sweating. The boils do pop, and when they do pop, it's very juicy, let's say.
Come on back.
Last time I counted, which was only from here to here, there's about 60 of them. If Dr. Lee cannot help me today, it would be a little disappointing because I'm in excruciating pain.
What's going on? What are you here for?
Well, I have these bumps since I was about 18 years old.
Visible cysts. Yes, right.
It's like when they get a certain size, they turn into boils. Like,
but yeah. So they get inflamed, and then do you actually able to sometimes squeeze things out, but do they come back, or do they?
Sometimes they come back, mm-hmm. But majority of the time, I can manage to squeeze it on out.
Okay.
And sometimes I have to squeeze it more than once, like over a few days.
Yeah. But it hurts, too. That's the problem.
Yeah, it's very painful. This isn't just like a pimple pain. This is like
deep
skin pain, you know?
Let me guess. These bumps that you have, I'm assuming you have
yes.
them. Most people have them around their chest and their back and things.
Right.
And I think a lot of these cysts are steatocystomas. We tend to see them kind of become more apparent during puberty time because they're kind of like the true oil cyst, like the sebaceous cyst, which means oil cyst.
Steatocystoma are a particular type of cyst that's very thin and lined with oil glands, and it's sort of secreting out into this area. Sometimes they get infected, and that's when they really hurt, and they have a potential to scar.
All right, I'll get you all set up, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
It's definitely gonna get messy, definitely. Ain't no ifs, ands, or buts, it will.
Do a lot of your friends know you have these?
My friends, my family, and like my whole backbone to this thing is my mother because like I call her and complain. Mm. Like, Mom, I'm hurting so bad. Like, Mom, help me. I'm ready to get popped and sliced and extracted and stitched and whatever else.
There's no way you can just squeeze them out because they don't have any opening really on the surface. So I'm gonna put some numbing in there first, of course. It's not too bad, my pinch is all right?
Yeah, no, they're not bad.
You're not even budging at all. Sorry.
No, you're fine.
You sure?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, you ready?
Okay.
Hi guys, it's Dr. Sandra Lee here. You guys also know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. I'm here to show you some behind the scenes of some of my favorite videos. And this one is probably definitely in my top five. It might even be my number one favorite video. This guy has two big dilated pores of Weiner. A dilated pore is essentially just a giant blackhead. And imagine a blackhead that gets trapped under the skin and more debris and dirt and skin cells get trapped in the skin, and it really kind of causes the skin to stretch open. So now you have a pore that is quite enlarged and it easily fills with dirt and debris, and that's why you get a giant blackhead in there.
Goodness, this little friend of yours. I think you're gonna lose a little weight today. It's like a rock.
See that they leave a dilated kind of hole that will shrink down. But really the only way that you can remove this sort of dilated opening on your skin is to excise the edges and refresh the wounds and be able to close it. I think to a lot of us papaholics, this is particularly satisfying and quite amazing, because to have something just pull out of, it's as if a little pebble or a little rock has been tucked under your skin. And you can see how dry and desiccated this is because it is rock hard. It's like, literally, like a little rock. You might have the award for the biggest blackheads. My goodness.
Oh, you're gonna actually, your clothes are gonna fit you better now. This thing is like a hump on your back. This is hard. I'm not hurting you, right?
Mm-mm.
They're like butter when they come.
Wow, oh my God, wow.
Taj has steatocystoma multiplex. He's got them all over his body. I just gotta make sure that we take as many of them off as we can with as little irritation and scarring as possible. Give it a little pinch, feel it.
Oh. I watched everything that was happening. I had the mirror here, watching stuff come out my skin.
See how they're all different? What's really interesting about steatocystomas is you can have one single person with multiple bumps like this, and out from each of these bumps comes something different.
Oh.
You're cute. They range from being really buttery.
Oh, man.
To kind of greasier and darker orange in color.
Wow.
I've seen ones that look like the consistency of a rubber band.
Oh, sorry, that one squirted.
They're fun to remove. They're fun to remove, very satisfying to watch.
Ooh.
Sometimes we do a guessing game. What color is it gonna be?
I think this one might be yellow. Ooh, God, and here it comes. Oh, it looks like a ribbon. Oh my God.
It is a ribbon.
You know how a ribbon is set up like flat but long? It was coming out like that. It was epic. Ooh, man, just look at that.
Good stuff.
That is excellent.
All right, darling, I see the contours of your clavicle now.
Yes, me too.
Looking good.
Don't even look
bumpy. Just stare at your mirror all the time now.
After the procedure, you can definitely tell the difference almost immediately. I'm ready to rock a shirtless body. I feel like 1,000 pounds of pus is lifted up off my shoulders. I feel like me again, really.